In my previous project, I was able to get the local XY coordinates of the tech device by calculating trilateration with each distance data obtained from each anchor device of UWB. The issue here is that it is difficult to determine the current location of a tag or user simply by showing the values of X and Y. Of course, you can see the graph of the distance from each anchor, but this only shows the data trend and is not very effective. So, in this project, I will try to set up a virtual environment to identify the user's local position in the 3D space effectively. I think this video shows you what apps I use and how they worked. There are many ways to visualize data. I personally like to use Unity based on C# script to show movement in 3D space. So I use Unity for this project. It also allows us to easily set up a 3D environment. So if you need to work in 3D, I recommend you try this. This is my preference, and I know everyone's taste may be different, so you may just use it as a reference. Okay, let's talk about 3D scanning with iPhone. If I remember correctly, Apple started having LiDAR module from the iPhone 12, so the 3D scanning quality increased by leaps and bounds. I'm gonna try scanning my garage using my iPhone 15 Pro Max. So I searched for room scanner app from App Store. Many apps had similar functions. They recognize the edge line between walls and show the rendering in real time. This is a function created using Apple's Room Plan API. It uses a LiDAR sensor to do real-time scanning and works very well. I downloaded one of these apps and scanned my garage. It was very fast at scanning the space, and since I could see the results on the screen in real time, I could immediately check if I missed anything while scanning. I scanned my garage like this, and this gave me an actual size of my garage. You know what? Before trying this, I didn't know the exact size of my garage. This says that my garage is 6.15 meters wide and 7.13 meters long. Now I need to export this to a file format that can be used in Unity. Unfortunately, the export supported by this app is not directly usable in Unity. It can be output to Apple's Universal Scene Description format, Alembic, which is an ABC file, and STL file used for 3D printing. Since this is a simple 3D object, I was able to export it as an STL file and then use an object converter to import it in Unity. This is my garage, but it looks very boring. However, it has the exact meter of width, length, and height, so it's very important in terms of actual measurement. After all, what I'm trying to do is represent the local position in reality to virtual position. Going back to App Store, I found a 3D scanner app that can do texture mapping. While most apps require a paid or in-app purchase to use all the features, this app is free to use all the features, which is really nice. I used this app to rescan my garage. My garage is so full of stuff that it's not good to do this kind of scanning. Of course, I clean up before scanning, but there's still a lot of stuff. Anyway, I scanned every nook and cranny and got this result. This is very interesting. As you know, the iPhone is great, but this is not a dedicated 3D scanner device. Nevertheless, it was possible to scan the space with good quality. The scan data created a total of 644 million points and 201,000 triangles. Since this application supports PLY type, so if you need point cloud type, you can export your scan data to PLY and use it. I use the OBJ file. I choose this because it can be imported directly into Unity. You can also import GLTF, but that also requires installing another package, so I choose the easiest way. When you import your scanned object in Unity, you will see a screen like this. How's it? I really like it. I'm really happy with this. I'm impressed that this kind of environment can be created with just my iPhone. Of course, it's possible to create a better quality 3D environment, but this isn't enough for this project. I was able to select a higher quality in the app, but it seems that the export is already fixed quality. Anyway, this allowed me to recreate my garage in a 3D environment. Do you remember the units used in the previous video? They were calculated in centimeters. However, in this environment, the default object import scale is 1 meter. So if you create a 1x1x1 cube, you can see that each side is 1 meter. Therefore, we will have to decide whether to use meters or centimeters in this project. I will mention it again in the next project. The two objects were created using different apps, but they are the same size. It seems that the accurate measurement was possible because they were scanned using LiDAR sensor. Today, I shared how I prepared my virtual environment. It's really fun to be able to set up such a system at a hobby level. It's really cool. This can be done with just my iPhone. If I get an Android phone with a LiDAR sensor, I will try that too. Alright, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.